Hello everybody, and welcome to Mega Man 9! And Booster 2 and last... well, not when last we left off. Let's just... this Mega Man 9. I think there's an introduction story? No, I think we have to wait for it. So, there we go.
I'm so sorry, please forgive me!
It is the year 20XX, and the world breathes a collective sigh of relief now that Mega Man has once again put an end to Dr. Wily's plans. For world domination. You know, those plans. As opposed to his plans to build a summer home. But then... night fell. Robots started going wild over the world. Could this be the Dr. Wily up to his old tricks? Dr. Light's laboratory. It's very tiny. Chun-Li? Wait a minute, Dr. Light, it's your robots. You're white. Those are the robots I created.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is not my doing. These robots are Dr. Light's creations. This proves he's had evil designs on the world all this time.
It's time I turned my efforts to world domination. Why don't you join me, Dr. Wily?
I can't join you. I've changed my evil ways. Sure I have. You can believe me. You need to stop this nonsense. I, Dr. Wily, have created my own robots to stop Dr. Light, but only your donations can help me complete them. Once my robots are finished, they will save the world!
We got another phone call. The phone's ringing off the hook. Literally, apparently. People keep calling Dr. Light to complain. What should we do? Answer the phone, maybe. For starters, I'm gonna do something about those robots! Thanks, Sega Man. Be careful out there. You haven't done this in a while. Okay, so there's the story. Apparently it's Dr. Light this time. But he completely forgot he did it, apparently. Because he's sending Mega Man out to stop it. Galaxy Man. Mega Man 9, as you can see, is a throwback to the old NES days. There's no charging, no sliding. But there are bolts. That was not the good. That was not what you were supposed to do. Ah, I remember. Those things will latch onto your head and fly forward while holding you.
Oh no.
That was a poor start. I am so embarrassed. I was thinking to myself, maybe I'm gonna be able to pull off a no damage run of this stage. No. This game includes challenges. They're not achievements. Not exactly, anyway. I think you can get achievements for completing the challenges. But, no, 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 yes. Excellent. This game is also the first one to include a female robot master. Name of Splash One. I believe the original design was a Splash Man, and they were going to make for the female robot master Honey Woman, and they changed it to Bee Man. Was it Hornet Man? I don't remember. Wrong button. I'm trying to change the my weapons, but apparently that function was not implemented. Yay! God, I love the turbo fire. Yep, there we go. Gotcha. Careful. Careful. Okay. Yay. Need lots and lots of screws. That one there. Do want. Hey. No, no, no. Phew. Galaxy Man. Power to generate black holes. What purpose would there be to create something this obscenely powerful? It creates black holes. can't even begin to sit to point out how dangerous that is. Yeah. I don't know what those challenges are for. I think the Eco Fighter was for beating a boss without any special weapons, but surely you get that for the first fight anyway. Black Hole Bomb. Oh no! The police have taken Dr. Light away! Dr. Light would never try to take over the world. This is definitely what he's doing. Now who's gonna deliver presents to the good boys and girls? Without a doubt. Don't worry, I'll clear Dr. Light's name. God, I hope you can't hear this coming out front with the conversation outside. To screw. That makes me sad. Fortunately, you can get rid of this guy pretty easy. It's almost like they're not very bright. That's what I was trying to avoid. Obviously. I swear I'm gonna beat one of these stages without dying. Conqueror now. I mean, I don't mind. Despite this looking like a, NES game. It was indeed downloadable content when it first came out for the PS3. I think it also came out for the Xbox 360, I don't remember. It's not something I really would pay attention to since I don't own one. I did. It broke on me. I decided to never use an Xbox again. Oh, that sucked. How you pressing, pressing? God damn it! Okay. What's he saying? Oh yes, DLC. You could. I think there were like a couple of challenge modes you could get. What? Oh, come on! Okay, that was my fault. I didn't see it coming that time. Jeez. Ow. So yes, downloadable content, yada yada yada. Couple of bonus things, and you could also play as Proto Man. Proto Man has all the moves from the later Mega Man games. The slide. The charging buster. Need health badly. I can't die here. Thank you. Yeah, sure, that was very quick. He jumps when you jump. It's very annoying. But he can't modulate his jumps. Something I just realized. You jump a little bit, he'll jump as high as he can. And that's how you get him. Good for me. Let's see. Jewel satellite. Who's weak against Jewel Satellite? I think it's Plugman. That's right, Plugman. His head is a plug. And yeah, so yeah, Proto Man is has all of the powers from the later Mega Man games, but he takes twice as much damage. Oh god. Trickery, that is. He also can't access shop, so he doesn't get bolts. god, oh god, oh god. Damn it. Irritation. Yes, it's very, very hard to be his proto man. Excuse me. Which is a shame, because I really like the proto man character. God damn it, game! That is just irritating. Supposed to do? What indeed? I may have a plan. It worked. That was close. Oh no. I can't get back up, can I? No, I cannot. Farfick nuke. I've had a lot of practice with this one. Said, you can't shop with the Proto Man. So if you want E-Tank, you have to get him the old-fashioned way. And there's an E-Tank in this stage. I don't care for these things. No, bad move. He had poop. No, it's alright. Need to refill my jewel satellite thing anyway. Patience. Stop it. Jewel the hell out of this guy. If I was Proto Man, that would have been a lot harder. Although, yeah, he also has his shield, which he will hold out in front of him when he jumps. And that will deflect just about anything that's fired at him. Which is handy. Alright, one more stage for this video, and that. Or at least until I don't know. Game over. I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet. One thing at a time, please. For obvious reasons. You don't have to jump on them like that. They're magnetic, so you'll stick to them. I shall show you. You see the trick, don't you? Totally should have worked. I'm upset now. I didn't want to be upset. Now it works. Give me a second, it takes me a little bit to get my timing. Yeah. Okay, it takes me a long time to get my time. I apologize. I don't like that. That is not a fun mechanic. I clench up, and I don't like it. See, as I was saying, you know, downloadable content, yada yada yada, Proto Man. There is no downloadable content for the Legacy collection, which is what this is. Instead, you have to beat the game at least once in order to unlock the, what would have been downloadable content. So I cannot play as Proto Man yet, but if I beat the game, I will. This is a feature they continued in, oh, for Christ's sake. Should've jumped on the cloud. Pretty sure I can. So yeah, they continued that in Mega Man 10. Whereas you can play as Proto Man from the outset, but the downloadable content, or the unlockable in this case, is to play as Bass. Unlike... Oh, Christ! I can't believe I screwed that up. That might be a game over. I wasn't counting. Nope. Okay, so yeah. Unlike, playing as Proto Man in this game, Bass still has his own story mode. And I wouldn't say story mode. But his own cutscenes. Proto Man does not get those. Which is sad because, you know, even Mega Man 3 had cutscenes. I did it again! Oh, I'm terrible. Alright. I will be right back. Well, not right back, this is the end of the video. So, when we come back, I will be at that save point. Or the restart point. Or maybe I'll do it at the, well, you'll see. I'm the Blue 32. This is Mega Man 9. TTFN. Ta-ta for now.